In this exercise, I would like to compute the unit tangent vector, the unit normal vector, and the unit binormal vector for the parameterized curve described as r of t equals cosine of t, sine of t, sine of 2t, and we are parameterizing this curve from 0 to 2 pi. So a couple of remarks before we start with our computations. These three coordinate functions are all periodic, so this curve will close up. In fact, let me put up a little image of this curve or a movie of it being traced out as t goes from 0 to 2 pi. Another remark is that these vectors t, n, and b are what we call the Frenet frame vectors. And then my final remark is that we are not interested in finding expressions for these three vectors as functions of time in their own right. We are only interested in what they are at one particular moment in time, that is t equals 0. So as we work through this computation, what I would like for you to do is focus on when we must keep the variable little t present, and when it's safe to plug in t equals 0. Just a quick rule of thumb, anytime you've got to differentiate, you need to be working with the variable. So I can't plug in t equals 0 and get rid of little t too quickly. However, we will also see that there are moments when perhaps we could start trying to simplify with the variable little t, but it's a lot faster if we just go ahead and let t equals 0. Okay, that's a little strange if you're not looking at what I'm talking about. So let's get started. Typically, with this kind of parameterized curve exercise, the very first thing to do is just go ahead and compute the velocity vector r prime. So whenever you're solving this kind of problem, it's like if you need a jumping off thing to do, do that. So let's just do r prime. Term by term differentiation, we're going to have that the first coordinate is the derivative of cosine of t, that's negative sine of t. And then differentiate sine of t, we get cosine of t. And then with the chain rule, when we differentiate the third coordinate function, sine of 2t, that will be 2 cosine of 2t. All right. So this is the velocity vector for this curve. And what we need in order to get our first Frenet frame vector, the unit tangent vector, is we need to take this vector and find its unit length version. That's going to give us this unit tangent vector t hat. For that, you take the velocity vector and divide it by the speed. Let me compute the speed on its own first. So what is the speed? It's like saying, what's the length of the velocity vector? That's going to be the square root of each of these coordinates squared and added together. So we'll have sine squared when I square that first coordinate from the velocity vector plus cosine squared. So the sine function squared, the cosine function squared, and then we will be left with 4 cosine of 2, oh, sorry, cosine squared, 2t, like that. Okay, see if I can draw a straight line. It's not too bad. Often I see students overlook this, and you want to really train yourself to recognize it. So anytime you're working with descriptions, whether it's curves or parameterized surface or something like that, and you've got sines and cosines, look for these moments. Look to have a sum of squared trig functions, sine squared and cosine squared, because with the Pythagorean identity, we know that that's 1. So we can say that this, the speed is 1 plus 4 cosine squared with the input 2t. Okay, so we have our velocity vector, we have our speed. We can divide the velocity vector by the speed to get the unit tangent vector as a function of time. And I do need that expression. So I do need to have a general form for t hat as a function of time. So again, we're going to get this by dividing the velocity vector by the speed. I could write negative sine over the square root, comma, cosine over the square root, comma, 2 cosine 2t over the square root. I encourage you, when you have this kind of scalar expression, which is going to be common to all three coordinates, to actually leave it out front. So I'm going to write this as 1 over the square root of 1 plus 4 cosine of 2t, that quantity squared, like this. Just leave that out front, and then we'll have negative sine of t, cosine of t, 2 cosine 2t. Okay, I would like to pause here for a moment. What I want you to do is go ahead and compute the unit tangent vector when t equals 0. To think that's straightforward. What do we need to do? Not too much. And then differentiate this expression. So we'll have t hat prime. Differentiate that expression because we need to do that in order to compute the unit normal vector n hat. But don't take it too far. Okay, so just compute the derivative, but don't simplify. I want to kind of point out a way that we can make our lives better because we know that we are really only interested in the moment when t equals 0. First, let's discuss what the unit tangent vector is when t equals 0, little t. We actually have two ways at this moment that we could compute it. And if we were only interested in that unit tangent vector at time equals 0, I would actually do it the second of the two ways I'm about to mention. The first way is might be where you went in your computation because we just wrote down this expression for the unit tangent as a function of time. Therefore, if we let time equal 0, we have the vector we want. So that's maybe the most natural way to proceed given the computations we've done so far. All right, if I let t equal 0, this is going to be 1 over the square root of 1 plus 4. Cosine of 0 is 1, don't forget. So that's going to be 1 over the square root of 5. Let me write that kind of over here just to save room. Oh, I'm about to write square root of 2 because that's such a famous square root. But what we want is square root of 5. And then the coordinates are going to be 0, 1, 2. So sine of 0 is 0, cosine of 0 is 1. So this is 2 times 1. Okay, that is the first way, based on what we've done so far, to say what this vector t hat at 0 is. The easier way, if we were going to stop with just the unit tangent vector, the easier way would have been to actually compute the velocity vector and only the velocity vector. Forget the speed and all of this. Plug in t equals 0 and then make that unit length. So let's check out loud and see if we get the same thing. If I take the velocity vector and I let the parameter little t be 0, we get 0, 1, 2. That's this vector here, 0, 1, 2. That is the velocity vector at that moment in time. And all we have to do to make it unit length is divide by the magnitude of this vector. So you could have gone straight from this to this. However, we are not stopping there because we also want to say what the unit normal and binormal vectors are. And for that, I need this expression for t in general because we have to differentiate it to get to the unit normal vector. Okay, so let's do that. You might already have it written down if you pause the video and work this out. I think I can fit it down here. It's going to be messy, but I'm not going to simplify it that much. So the unit normal, I shouldn't say that. I got ahead of myself there. I'm just going to say t hat prime. Like that. It's going to be the derivative of this expression. I like having the scalar out front. I think it's easier to do a very basic product rule than to have distributed this to each coordinate and then kind of had larger expressions to differentiate. That's just my personal preference. You might feel differently. If I differentiate this with a product rule, we will have, okay, this is like 1 plus 4 cosine 2t to the negative 1 half power. So negative 1 half comes down, leaving me with 1 plus 4 cosine squared, the argument of 2t. It was negative 1 half to have the square root in the denominator. Subtract 1, we get negative 3 halves. We are not done because I now need to do chain rule here. So that's going to be negative 8. Sine of 2t times 2. Kind of a lot going on. All right, so let's see. This was 1 plus 4 cosine squared of 2t, cosine 2t squared. I never really like saying the squared trig functions out loud, but anyway, moving along. It's this expression raised to the negative 1 half power. So the negative 1 half comes down. We take this, raise it to the negative 3 halves, differentiate the inside. It's kind of a lot going on with this term. So derivative of cosine is negative sine. The 2 comes down, A2t times 2 from the chain rule. Okay. That's the derivative of the first, and then we just write the second because we're doing product rule. So it's derivative of the first times the second. I'm just going to write dot, dot, dot. Otherwise, I will run out of room, and also I kind of run out of like enthusiasm if I'm writing too much. Then we will do 1 over the square root. Like that. And then term by term differentiation, and this is really not too bad. So this is going to be negative cosine of t, negative sine of t, and then negative 4 sine 2t. 4 sine of 2t, where I've not run off the screen. Okay. This is not the unit normal vector, but I claim that we've done enough at this point to stop and get the unit normal vector that we need. What is the unit normal vector n hat in general? It's this vector, t hat prime, divided by its own length. It's analogous to how t hat is this vector divided by its own length. If I wanted an expression for n hat in general as a function of t, I would need to take this whole expression, compute its length, and then take this and divide it by its own length. But that's not what we're going to do because we are only interested in the moment when the parameter is 0. So to get n hat at 0, I'm going to do the second way that we worked out what this vector was. So if you recall, I said, hey, there was a shorter way to say what this unit tangent vector is. Take the velocity vector, write it down at t equals 0, and then divide that by its own length to make it unit length. Same thing here. Let's plug in little t equals 0, get a vector of numbers, and then divide that by its own length. So I'm going to leave a little space in case I need to divide out front, kind of like we have the 1 over square root of 5. Let's plug in little t equals 0. I knew when I wrote dot, dot, dot here that we had nothing to worry about because sine of 0 is 0. So we have a factor here that's going to be 0. This whole thing goes to 0. Okay, so this whole part gets wiped out when we're computing the unit normal vector at t equals 0, little t equals 0. Coming over here, we are going to have, let me go ahead and write 1 over the square root of 5 out front. Negative 1. Okay, I'm not done. This looks wrong. The 1 over the square root of 5 was here, but the thing is we need to make this vector unit length. You could work out that the length of this is 1 over the square root of 5, divide, cancel, or you could just realize, hey, this is a unit length vector. So let me get rid of this positive leading coefficient, so that our unit normal vector is actually just negative 1, 0, 0. So just nicely worked out that this was actually giving us n hat on its own. We have t at 0, we have n at 0. We don't have any more derivatives to take. In order to work out the unit binormal vector, all we need to do is cross these. As long as they are non-zero, the result will actually already be unit length. So the unit binormal vector is a really nice thing to work out in this kind of situation. No differentiation or anything like that. Just take a cross product of these vectors we already have, and the result will be unit length. So you get right to it. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. You can pause if you'd like, but I think we can just immediately say that the vector b hat when time is 0 is going to be, I'll leave the 1 over the square root of 5 out front. You can think of that as a scalar times this cross this. First component is going to be 1 times 0 minus 2 times 0, so that's 0. And then we'll have 2 times negative 1 minus 0 times 0, so that's going to be negative 2. And then 0 minus negative 1 times 1, overall that's 1. You'll notice comparing it with the unit tangent vector that yes, it really is unit length, similar coordinates. Just trying to make this better and I made it worse. Okay, let's do this. It's unit length and these vectors should form a mutually perpendicular set. So if you take the dot product of any pair, you'll get zero. That is indeed what happens. And we're done. Okay, so let me recap. We wanted to find the Frenet frame, t hat, n hat, and b hat for this parameterized curve at one particular value of the parameter. Where did we need the parameter and where could we substitute in the value of the parameter that we're interested in? Well, you need the parameter around as long as you need to take a derivative. That means that you need the velocity and the speed in terms of general t so that you can write down the unit tangent vector as a function of t. Because the last thing you need to do with that is differentiate it. Once you get to t hat prime, you don't need to keep the variable little t around anymore. What you can do is plug in. You might get a vector which isn't unit length, but that's okay. You just make it unit length. And then you have your unit tangent vector, unit normal vector, cross them to get your unit binormal vector. Okay, this wraps up this computation. Thank you for your attention.